So, we will keep chatting, keep talking as we go. I have some 6-7 slides which I have prepared just to structure my conversation, because otherwise I'll ramble on. So, let's just go ahead. I have put this here because you all are in first year and you all have thought somewhere in your mind that, okay, maybe I'll pick up marketing and I'll do blah blah. I'm doing MBA to be an entrepreneur, but I don't know how my MBA is going to help me to be an entrepreneur. I really don't know what is there in the mind when you are studying MBA to be an entrepreneur, okay? So taking Sachin's example, someone who recalls the finance guest lecture, but how will you use it for the next 2 years? How will you use it to choose your specialization? What's happening in the world? Will you choose your specialization because of how the economy is moving? Will you choose it because in your mind you have thought ki ye theek rahega? Will you choose it because your family says so, your peer group says so? What is it which is driving you? I'll just structure it a little bit to help you in your 2 years journey, so that when you come out, you really know what you wanted and what you have achieved. Okay? So we'll move in that direction. That's why choice or voice. By choice or voice, I mean, did you choose it or did the voices tell you to choose it? The voices may be the industry, the economy, peer group, parents, anybody. Alumni, faculty, industry experts, so-called industry experts like us. So what is it that made you choose? So is it a choice or was it by voice? We all say that, but you will realize that it's more the voices which are speaking, not the choice. Okay, so now we have this. Why are you studying MBA? Entrepreneur sir, sorry, aap last bench mein baithe ho mere session mein. Sachin sir, aap MBA kyun padh rahe hain? Entrepreneur banne ke liye MBA ki kya zarurat hai? What is the requirement? 2 years, money, effort. Entrepreneurs, so you know the big entrepreneurs, right? 12th pass, 10th pass, graduates.
I'll get the knowledge, what is all required to be an entrepreneur.
How? Do you think studying a few subjects will gain you that knowledge? How? Make me understand a little bit more. How? How do you think studying all these subjects, your corporate finance, HR, quantitative research, behavioral, OBE, how does it organization behavior, how does it help you become an entrepreneur? Entrepreneur doesn't mean suddenly you become Bill Gates, right? You have to build it from scratch. So how will it help you? What made you think that an MBA degree will help you become an entrepreneur?
Well, I learned the different strategies, what is all required.
And you think all those strategies are the ones who succeed? Jo aap kitab se padh ke nikloge?
No, ma'am, but it will help. Definitely
help. Okay. Fair enough. Thank you. So, okay, he feels it will help. How it will help, we are not yet clear. But the feeling is, if you have an MBA degree, it helps you become an entrepreneur. Okay? That's the feeling that he has right now. That's a feeling. It's not tried and tested. All the big entrepreneurs are not MBAs, right? So, in fact, let me tell you a small little story. The last organization that I was in, which is Publicis Media, it's a French multinational company, and we acquired a small company called Convonix, which is in performance media, digital company, which does performance marketing. These are big words, you'll learn it as you go along. Just know that this is a digital company which Publicis acquired. Two boys started it when they were in college with an idea. Sarfaraz was one and Pallav Jain and Sarfaraz Khan. These were the two boys who started working in digital media when they were in college. By the time they graduated, they had built the company to a certain level. No MBA, no nothing. Ran the company for 10 years, brought it to a certain level, sold it to Publicis. After selling it to Publicis, they stayed on for 3 years. Usually in any acquisition, there is a 3-year lock-in period. So they stayed on in the organization for 3 years as the COO, CEO, and in between they went to get their MBA degree from IIM, Ahmedabad and Calcutta. Both of them went. They did not have an IIM degree when they became an entrepreneur. They added their degree, and this is a recent example. They are 33, 34 year old. This is like, what, 3 years back, they sold Convonix. So it's not there, your contemporaries more or less, right? So we feel an MBA degree will help us become an entrepreneur. Right, wrong, we don't know. It's still exploration. So how many of you feel an MBA degree will give you a job? Raise your hands. Okay. Versus, so MBA degree versus being a graduate, you have better chances of getting a job. Hands raise karo bhai. Nothing to be scared of. Okay, most of you believe that in the versus thing and a degree gets you a job. Okay. How many of you think job to mil jayegi? Career kar paoge? Career banegi isme? What is the difference between a job and a career? I'm sorry, I'm asking these questions simply so that I can get some clarity in your mind, that's all. Your mind process will start thinking. That's the only reason. So just think. You don't have to answer. Just think that just getting a job, does it mean you have a career? Why no? Or why yes? Please.
Job is just for earning money and
career is for future. So in future you don't want to earn money. Then, so a little more. I get what you are saying, but I want it for all of them. So a little more, define it a little more. Career means?
Promoting to upper levels.
Okay, so in organizations nowadays, there is metric structure. There is no upper level. It's a very flat structure. So what does upper level mean? Promoting to upper level means what?
Higher levels.
Go ahead. Say whatever is there in your mind. Nobody, I don't know anything I'm telling you. Well, whatever you tell me is my learning today. So it means what?
Production manager from the CEO.
So it's again you're talking designations. So, and I'm telling you now, there are no designations. We have only 5 designations. Associate, Senior Associate Manager, VP, Senior VP. Finish. So, what does getting higher designations mean?
Higher pay.
See, it's coming back to money. Good. Thank you. At least there are some answers I'm getting. Okay, great. Now tell me how many of you are doing it because you think that a postgraduate degree, any postgraduate degree helps. Anyone? Just doing a graduate degree does not help. You need to have a post-graduation. Post-graduation in whatever direction is fine, depending on what you want to do in future, what job you want. Anyone? Would you have considered mass comm, not an MBA? Anyone would have considered mass comm and not MBA? No one? So no one thinks that a postgraduate, just for the degree, it is important to study MBA, right? Agreed?
Yes.
Great. So we'll go. Entrepreneur, I have already written. You want to be an entrepreneur, that is why you are wanting to get that degree. Great. So I've heard all these answers actually. These are all answers. I have interviewed now in my span of 19 plus years of experience, I have interviewed now all levels, higher CEOs, 6-7 CEOs in my career span. And I have interviewed so many fresh, millions now, I have just lost count. And I get all these answers. These are all answers which I get. Now I have a last question for all of you. How many of you are pursuing MBA because you want to pursue a passion. Okay, I want to hear from you guys. You're the first one who just raised it. So tell me.
Ma'am, actually our dream of getting to the post of CEO or something bigger in my life, and MBA will just help me out getting there fast.
So the passion is all about the position?
To raise my living and...
So it's about the position, the stature, the position. There's nothing wrong in that, don't get me wrong. So the passion is about the position, the stature, and the perks which come with it, right? Fantastic. Can I have your name?
Ishani.
Ishani. Thank you, Ishani. There were five people who raised. The second one. Yes, please.
Ma'am, I think I've got leadership skills.
Mm-hmm.
And through MBA, I want to get professionally groomed to be a more capable entrepreneur.
To be a more capable entrepreneur. Okay, so you feel your passion is to be an entrepreneur.
Leadership.
And for that, you need this degree.
Yes.
Okay, great. May I have your name too?
Harmeet Singh.
Harmeet. Have a seat, Harmeet. Next one, please.
Ma'am. Good morning, my name is Varun Sharma. Ma'am, during when I was doing my job, I found that I was not good in technical that much, but I was good in managing things.
During your? You were working?
No, I was working.
You were working?
Maruti.
You were working in Maruti.
Yes, ma'am.
So rather than the technicals, and after your graduation, you started working in Maruti?
Yes, ma'am.
So what did you do in graduation? What was your subject?
Ma'am, mechanical engineering.
Mechanical engineer. So after you started working with the yoga, I'm better at this.
Yes, ma'am. Technically, I was not that good because my department was from quality, I changed to counseling.
Ah, fantastic. So you switched gears when you figured out that this, whatever I have learned, is not something which I'm really, really going to succeed in. So let me switch gears in which I will succeed.
Yes, ma'am.
And that's where you have started doing MBA.
Yes.
Fantastic. Have a seat. Anyone else? Five. I saw five hands. Yeah. Now somebody is hugging.
I want to pursue this because I always wanted to own my own business into hospitality. To run a chain of hotels.
Okay.
So, this would help me in reviewing my ideas and making my own plans and how I can work with this. But I'm fit for this thing or something other.
Okay, so you have a vision and you want to now, you were thinking that this will help, not help, we'll figure it out. But first, let's start. That's right. Oh, thank you, Anushka. Have a seat. Okay, so now we have, let me give you, so no one is wrong, no one is right. Reality is just a perspective. Having said that, let me give you my perspective and my journey a little bit, okay? So, as you know, I belong to now not so small, but at that point of time small, town in Assam called Guwahati, which is the capital. This one is the capital, it's in Guwahati itself. So, whenever I have, I started all through in Kendriya Vidyalaya because my father was in Assam Civil Services. And after that, after my 10th result, where at that point of time, I could top. Nowadays, 99% is not topper. So, up to Kai Guru. But that point of time, I topped. And then all the teachers pushed me towards science. They said, take science. You have scored well, 80 in maths, 80 in physics, chemistry, whatever. So, please take science, please take science. Class 9, I had read economics. 9 and 10, we had economics. So, I was very clear, I wanted to study economics more. That point of time, why economics was not so clear, but I was fascinated with the subject. And I wanted to do economics. And then, when everybody was pushing me towards science, I only said that if you have economics in science, then I'll do it, otherwise no. They didn't have. That was, what, 1989? So science did not have economics. So then I said, then I'll go to arts. I don't care. So, lot of pressure. You cannot imagine the pressure. Because that point of time, every school wanted to have good results. So they want the students to move into science and do good results there. Arts mein kaun results dekhta hai, kaun kya karta hai. So I did not. So I did my plus two. I topped in the school again. And then there was pressure that where to study, right? Which college to go, what to do, blah, blah, blah. Very protected environment. I could not, I was not allowed. By the way, that point of time, I pushed and I said I want to study in better colleges, economics. And economics, the cutoff percentages are very high. In that point of time also, here or now also. So LSR, I missed the cutoff percentage in plus two by 1%, but I got through in English, history, blah, 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 that kind of four or five subjects. So again, pressure from parents that if you really want to study in one of the top colleges, LSR at that point of my time was also the best. So go study there, you can take history or you can take geography or you can take sociology and then move into economics. So again, I refused. I said, no, economics is what I want to study and I don't care. I'm going to, that is what pulls me, calls me, and I'm going to pursue that. So I studied economics in, I did economics honors from Cotton College, Guwahati. So Cotton College is one of the oldest, it was established in 1901, and in Northeast is one of the best colleges. So I studied from there, finished my graduation in economics. By that time, I figured out I wanted to do an MBA in HR. Now, why an MBA in HR? Because economics taught me a lot about the market, the businesses, how business functions, the market functions, how dynamics change. What economics did not have was that how did this dynamics impact human beings, us? Because we are driving the economies, right? There are people behind these economies, whether it is the policy or whether it is the investments or whether it is governments, it's all people, nothing else. I said, fair enough. Now, if this is the business side of it, the market side of it, what about the people side of it? It fascinated me. How are people driving it? How can one Modi drive a GST and demonetization when none other had done it? Fascinating. So then MBA HR was decided. So when I again, by God's grace, topped in graduation, then I just got, I did not go anywhere, I just took admission after whatever test says, etc. in university, and everyone kept telling me, why don't you take finance? Why don't you take finance? Marketing, nobody actually pushes you to take. But why don't you take finance? No, I took HR. And now at that point of time, HR jobs were again very few. You don't get HR job. My first job was here in Delhi, and now it's been 19 years. I have taken breaks because of my child, but even during the breaks, I have got assignments from organizations coming up. I take small pride in the fact that every organization I have left has called me back. Every. Cyber media I left, you see my LinkedIn profile, you'll figure out. They called me back. Evaluserve I left, they called me back. JWT I left, they called me back. Publicis I left, they're yet to call me back because I left last year. Cheil I left, Cheil called me back. So right now I'm in Cheil. What I'm trying to say through all this is that what drives or what makes success is passion and focus. Nothing else. Degree, all that you get, MBA A through or whatever, is incidental. It will come because you have the passion and focus. It is not because of this that your passion and focus is getting built. So there has to be clarity here. What is it that I enjoy doing? What is it that I want to do? And then where is it I want to go? If I am doing an MBA, I need to know how does it help me in the entrepreneurial skill sets. And from today I will start it. Today I will move in that direction. I will not wait to figure out how this degree gives me that leverage. If I jumped into it, I need to figure out how to leverage it from today. The passion needs to drive you. Entrepreneur in what area? What will you do? How is it that other entrepreneurs are working? Have you joined the entrepreneurial forum? So it's not about the degree. It's about what's driving you inside, which will make you succeed. And it's the focus. I keep telling my son who's in 10th, focus, 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 and no hocus pocus. Until unless you focus, you will not excel. For sure, take it from me. I'm an old woman now. So take it from me, it will not work. Okay, so you come here. Did you sleep last night? You did? I'm feeling very bored with my session. Come. Come, he slept off. No worries, it's okay to sleep off. It reflects on me, not on you. But I want you to listen on some stuff. Okay, so now let's go to the next. How will you grow? By growth, I don't mean position, I don't mean money. Wo sab jhak maar ke aata hai. I've learned from my life. It's not about Amit Khan's movie. I've learned from my life that all the money, position that you look for, wo jhak maar ke aayega. If you have this, skill plus passion and commitment, will give you job, will give you career, will give you excellence. And if you have excellence, people will come to you. You don't have to go to anyone. Whether as an entrepreneur or as a professional, anywhere, any field, teacher, anything, any profession. If you excel, it's only then everything else will come. If you run after everything else, rather than excellence, you will get a job, livelihood, skill plus job, livelihood, yes? Maruti 800, then something else, then something else, then BMW, blah, blah. Skill plus job plus structured path will give you a career. Promotions, there's a structured path. 2 years I want to become this. 3 years I want to earn this. 4 years I want to earn this. That's a career. But skill plus passion and commitment is job, career, and excellence. Don't forget this slide. The only ask from all of you, and that's why I woke you up, is that don't forget this. That's the only thing which is true and the only thing which will help you. Strive for excellence in whichever area you go, whatever you do. And if it fails you, you come back and give me one tight slap. I'll take it from you. But it's my commitment, it will never fail. Okay, so moving on. What should you expect in the world? You're still living in a cocoon. You're still parents. अभी भी घर जाओ तो ठूस ठूस के खिलाएंगे खिलाएंगे सब कुछ. मेरा बेटा दुबला हो गया है, मेरी बेटी को पता नहीं क्या हो गया, सो नहीं रहे हो, क्या कर रहे हो, यू नो. सो इट्स ऑल लॉन्ग पेरेंट्स. आई एम अ मदर, आई नो. सो इट्स ऑल द सेम. बट द वर्ल्ड इज नॉट सो कोकोनिंग, राइट? द वर्ल्ड इज डिफरेंट. सो व्हाट डू यू एक्सपेक्ट व्हेन यू गो आउट इन टू द वर्ल्ड विद ड्रीम्स, thinking that ab MBA mil gaya hai, ab to main naukri karungi aur CEO banungi, ya ab to MBA ho gaya hai, ab I'll become, I'll start my own thing and I'll succeed, right? What should you expect when you go out after 2 years? What you expect is this word, VUCA. Have you heard of VUCA? Have you heard, anybody has spoken about the VUCA world to you? What is the VUCA world? Right? तू तो आधा लेक्चर नहीं सुना तूने, तो मैं अलग से क्लास में डिसाइड हूँ. सो ओके, सो आई विल एक्सप्लेन VUCA. VUCA इज, V इज वॉलेटाइल, U इज अनसर्टेन, C इज कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड A इज एम्बिगुअस. दैट्स द VUCA वर्ल्ड एंड दैट्स व्हाट द वर्ल्ड इज ऑल अबाउट. You might think many things, the world will be VUCA. And it's more and more going towards VUCA. More. So now what is it? I know you can't read it, I'm sorry. Jaya is not here, so maybe this slide can be just given to the students. I'd like them to see this. So volatile means it's fast change without a clear predictable trend or pattern. Everything is changing fast. Technology is changing fast. How we are doing business is changing fast. Everything, every small thing is changing. There is no predictability. You cannot predict a pattern. Everything goes and it keeps changing, changing, changing. So I'm going to now walk. So there is going to be frequent changes, unpredictability. You cannot predict anything. MBA degree will get me a job, but I can't predict it. There's so many MBAs. But having said that, in our business model, we are into advertising and marketing. The client, the largest client, because it's a Samsung group, is Samsung. So Samsung changes every day, it's brief. What does advertising and communication mean? It means that you reach out to the consumer through different mediums. Whether it is TV commercial, whether it's a retail outlet, whether it's a billboard, whatever it is, you reach out to the consumer. How you reach out is what we do. We write the script, we direct it. Any TV commercial that you see of Samsung is made by Cheil. Any retail outlet that you see is conceptualized, designed, rolled out, and maintained by Cheil. So we are into that business of creativity and marketing communication. Every hour, the client changes the brief. Every hour. And if you are unable to perform or deliver, business is gone. Because somebody else is sitting there to deliver. So this is, the whole scenario is very volatile, it is uncertain, and it is complex. It is so complex, there are so many variables. You start trying to do a job, there will be 500 things which will come in, which is going to make you succeed or fail. How do you deal with it? How do you deal with all the complexities? This game, GST demonetization, we are still dealing with the complexities. If anybody has parents who are entrepreneurs, they will tell you. The pain. Since years and years and years we have been working in a certain way, suddenly there is a change. And that change is also not constant. It's ever changing. The GST keeps changing. These are big changes, right? So these are changing the economy. Forget these big changes. Even in organizations, briefs are changing. Consumers are changing. If my Note 5 is for a certain target audience, but then Note 7 bombed. How do you change quickly? Who is your target audience? How do you grab into them? So decisions change. Because of the complexities, because of the fact that we are so now connected with the whole world, that everything changes very fast. It's complex and it changes fast. And the last one is ambiguous. Nobody can predict this is the path. This is the path. So nobody can predict that if I get a MBA, then I can become an entrepreneur. Nobody can predict that even if I don't get an MBA, I cannot become an entrepreneur. There is no prediction. It's all ambiguous. It's all fluid. And that is why I keep going back to passion. Only excellence is going to thrive in this VUCA world. And I'll tell you how to deal with each of these things. How do you deal with the volatile world? Any answers? How do you deal with the volatile world? Aapko pata hi nahi kal kya hone wala hai. How do you deal with it? For example, let's take a small example related to your life. You are walking from this building to another building for your class. And every day you face a new obstacle. You don't know what that obstacle is going to. How do you deal with it? Tell me. I'm here. Be attentive, yes. Be cautious. Caution might not take you anywhere then. In the time that you need to go to attend the class. Okay? Careful, cautious, basically, right? And be attentive. Okay? Let me just extrapolate on the be attentive part of it. Because you need to reach your class at a certain point of time for that fantastic lecture who will really give you some good inputs, right? Or maybe the attendance is required, right? So, and there is an obstacle every day. to ensure that you deal with volatility, you need to have a vision. The vision is to reach the glass. That is one part of the vision, which is the goal. The vision is to get the degree, get the knowledge. If that is the vision, then I need to attend this class. If I need to attend this class, I have to go this route. If I have to go this route, there are going to be obstacles, right? Prepare. Yes, prepare, prepare, prepare. If you are too cautious, then you are going to fail. If you are too risk-taking, you will get shattered by the obstacles. So you need to, my vision is that. For that, I need to ensure, I need to prepare myself, okay, these are the eventualities. Some things, miracles are happening, aliens are coming down, to separate thing. But these are the 20 obstacles which can come in. A tree might fall, a block cart might block the road, or whatever. These are the 10. If these are the 10 obstacles, how do I prepare myself? You need to have a vision. Until unless you have a vision, either you will give up because you are not a risk taker, or you will give up because there was no time and you kept struggling with the obstacles, or you will give up because you are disheartened. Whatever you do, you could not reach. Right? Vision is very important to deal with a volatile world. Be clear. Next is your uncertain. So uncertainty means there are frequently disruptive changes and unpredictability, unknown outcomes. So basically you have decided you need to reach that classroom, classroom number one. You reach classroom one, you figure out, oh man, the class is in classroom number two. It's not in one. It got changed at the last minute. And you don't have time now. The lecture would have started. So how do you deal with this unpredictability which is happening? For that, you need to have a wider understanding of the whole school bloody building. But you need to have an understanding of the whole school. That, okay, classes kahan kahan ho sakte hain. 2 mein ho sakta hai, 3 mein ho sakta hai, OBK class can happen in class number 2, 3, 1, 4. If you know only class number 2, and you know the route to only class number 2, and you end up not attending the class because it has changed. So you need to know wherever in the building are the classrooms, and so that quickly when you reach, you know the route, and you quickly figure out how to go to class number 2. You might lose 5 minutes, but that's okay. So vision ke saath saath, you need to have understanding. Understanding comes only when you are focused towards excellence. Huh? Because excellence is driven by passion. And passion will drive you to acquire more and more knowledge of the area that you are interested in. Next comes your complex. How do you deal with complexities? For complexities, you need to have clarity of thought process. That's all. No situation, so all situations are complex if you are not very clear. And all situations are simple if our thought process is clear. We don't get distracted. We know what we want, where we have to go. We know the obstacles which are going to come. We know that it's going to be unpredictable. That's why we know how we will move. Then there is no complexity. So let it all come. Let GST come. Because I have wider perspective, I know Canada has implemented GST, so I'll maybe pick it up quickly here. Or maybe I know how the government works, so and the system works, so that, or I know 5 people who have been in Canada and have come to India, and they know about GST, quickly speak to them and pick it up. All this you will know only when you were totally focused on your knowledge area, on your subject, and wanted to gain more and more there. It will not come because you are doing the course curriculum or getting the degree. Right? Last one is ambiguity. Ambiguity is, you know, what is real. So in this world, whenever you corporate world, whenever you go out, you'll feel that there are many things which are deemed to be real but are not. Because, simply because different levels, different decisions change. So you have been communicated, this is the brief and this is the reality and this is how you are going to do one work. Let's take a simple example. For example, in Samsung, there are, like someone said, there is a CEO, there is a manager, there is something. So your manager, who's the guy you talk to every day, gives you a brief, says that this is the work which needs to be done, right? You come back, you start doing that work. Then there comes a time when the manager's supervisor has to see the work. He sees the work and he said, no, this is not the brief. Who told you? So for you, what was real till that time becomes a false situation. What do you do? How do you cope with such situations? Let me put it on you. You have an exam, OB exam. You go, you prepare yourself, do everything, go to give an OB exam, and then the teacher says, hey, no, today is not OB, this is quantitative research exam. What am I supposed to do now? I was OB par ke aaya tha. So the only way you can survive such kind of situations is if you are agile. If you are agile and innovative, and to be agile, you have to have clarity. To be have clarity, you have to have understanding. To have understanding, you need to have vision. To have vision, you need to have passion. Got it? Anyone who has come here has done so much of hard work. You are all sincere kids. You are all fantastic kids. You are a part of the cream which has been selected in this institute. Don't lose it simply because you didn't have the passion to move in a certain direction. Find your direction and move in that direction. Do not listen to any of the voices except your own. Don't listen to anything. And believe me, this is one to take. Hear everyone. Take knowledge. But listen to the voice which tells you from inside that this is my choice. And here by choice, I don't mean the choice of profession. I also mean the choice of subject that you want to be in, the area you want to be in. Because like he figured out, after doing his engineering, he figured out that, Gaurav, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. After doing his engineering, he figured out, hey, it's not for me. But coming in the real world, he figured out, hey, it's not for me. I'm better at something else. 4 years mechanical engineering. How much he would have slogged? How much he would have put an effort in? Even after joining Maruti, kitna effort mara hoga? Uske baad he is coming back to this. Clear your mind now. And just move ahead. Okay, so now next thing is, now let's come to the real world. What do we look for in freshers? Okay, so what is it that I look for? I was just giving an example to Dr. Shifali when I was talking about, I've been trying to hire a HR fresher in my team. Forget the organization right now. I'm trying to hire a HR fresher in my team, and 4 months, I haven't even hired one person. So my bottleneck is that all the kids who come, I only tell them one thing. I ask them one thing. First, why did you choose HR? Many things depend on that answer. And the second is that how sincere, how hardworking, how committed are you to the work that I will give you? The work that I will give you can be a simple filing. But I want to know, how will you improve it? How will you do it? How are you committing yourself to create excellence out of even that filing? You convince me of that in the next 10 minutes, the job is yours. Till date, I have not been convinced. You wanted to ask something? Okay. Till date, I have not been convinced. People give me answers like, oh, there was, my friends are in HR, they're doing good jobs. So I also thought I'll get into HR. somebody says that I didn't like finance, marketing, I didn't want to do sales, that's why I went into HR. Somebody else, I don't know if this all these reasons resonate with any one of you. So somebody else says that, my teachers felt that I'll do good in HR, so I came to HR.
And then what type of answer do you expect?
Yeah, see? Like me or anyone else in my position, whether in HR or anything else, expects I did HR because I wanted to do HR. And I wanted to do HR not because I like talking to people, because I know HR can drive 1, 2, 3 things in organization which gives me a kick. That's your passion speaking. It's not just the job interview speaking. What gives you that kick? What is that makes you come to office every day? Along with the 30% in when you are in the early stages of your career, 50% work kachra hi hota hai. 80% kabhi kabhi kachra hota hai. Wo that 30% should give you that kick. If that is giving it that kick, your career is made, I'm telling you. Wo figure out what gives you that kick. If you take 6 months and say, hey, I'm bored. This is not giving me kick, this is giving me kick. This is not giving me kick, this is giving me kick. No excellence. And without excellence, you cannot survive in this VUCA world. No entrepreneur can survive, no professional can survive. If you really want to be the best, you have to give it your best in terms of your focus, commitment, and more and more and more, learn more about that subject. That's it. Your aim should not be that I become a manager or blah, blah, blah. Your aim should be that who's that person who's considered the best in this job, in this organization, I'll replace him or her in 5 years or 6 years. That's the aim. That's the vision. From there, backward planning. That okay, for doing that, what is it that I need to do? What are the unpredictabilities? What are the ambiguities? What are the obstacles? So what we look for is clarity. Are you clear? Why you did what you did? And why are you coming here to do what you are planning to do? Entrepreneur nahi ban paaye, job le liya. Job nahi chali, entrepreneur ban gaye. Try not to do that. Avoid that. I have had so many job interviews when people come back and tell me that, oh, after college I became an entrepreneur. We have acquired a recent company. That guy, Nikhil, fantastic guy. He's a 30-year-old and very smart, very intelligent guy. He's our technology solutions head in a company, the digital company that we have acquired. His CV shows that initial 3 years he was an entrepreneur, then he moved into a job. When I asked him, and he has done his MBA, by the way. So then I asked him that, why did you not pursue your entrepreneurship? His answer was that, I tried, but there are many things which I did wrong and I could not survive. And I spent 3 years, then I thought, let me get into a job where the stability of the money is coming in, the salary is coming in every month, and let me learn, then maybe someday I will do it. I told him, I disagree. You should have stuck to it. If that is your passion, it has to be from inside. It has to give you a kick. There is nothing called failure. It cannot be because that's the fashion. Everybody wants to be an entrepreneur these days. What, where, why, how many business models have succeeded, how many business models have failed, how much investment do you need? Even after investing, you need to make the right decisions at the right time and need to be able to survive in the VUCA world. Are organizations even considering entrepreneurs? Snapdeal, huge failure. I'm hiring people from Snapdeal at half their CTCs, let me tell you. So if you are not focused and if you are not clear in your ideas, thought process, again I'll link it back to excellence. And excellence, I'll link it back to passion. Think about what you are doing, where you are going, what is your vision, how do you want to move ahead. Otherwise, it's not going to happen. Next is ethics. We look for ethics. No shortcuts. So, in fact, Samsung as a group is very, very high on ethics. So anything which is unethical, anything that your parents have taught you, and all Indian parents, they teach well as the first thing. You don't show in the organization, it is not acceptable. So your ethics is a huge thing. Next is agility. How agile you are. Are you able to balance? In Publicis, we have a concept called T-talent. I cannot spread my hands, but it's T-talent, it's T. That means you specialize in one and you should be able to pick up multi. Right? That's what every organization is looking for right now. If you say, hey, I'm great in data analytics, but then I'm unable to manage the business side of it, or I'm unable to manage my team, or I'm unable to have communication in terms of new business pitches, then your growth is limited. You need to be a T-talent. And we have started training people to be T-talent. Okay, then flexibility, of course. You have to be flexible. When I joined Cheil back last year, so I came in HR. Immediately, within 4 months, they gave me legal. So I'm now managing the legal department also. In another 3 months, admin also came. I'd given away admin in my last team saying that I don't know how people do these things and how they, the ethics is very ambiguous there. There's no clarity, so I didn't want to do it. But it's come back. So you have to be flexible. You cannot say, I will not do this. You follow your passion, but along with it, if you have to do something because the situation organization demands this, even as an entrepreneur or as a professional, you need to be flexible to do that. You need to be flexible in your thought process. Learn, unlearn, relearn. First you learn, then you unlearn, then you relearn. That's the only way you grow. If you stick to your learning, nahi maine to aise hi sikha tha, bas, again the same. And the last which we see and always we say is passion equal to success. They are interlinked. How passionate. Especially Korean companies, very, very passionate people. You should see Koreans work. They work, they take it to a different level. They are working 24 hours, and that's why it's a very, very small economy, but it is one of the 20th largest economies in the world. And India is where we are. Still struggling. Look at the talent in this room itself, and we are still struggling. You know, so in fact, I think ancient India was much, much more successful than we are today. Ancient India, if you remember, had much, much bigger milestones than we have today. What we have today, somebody would have done it before. What ancient India had, at that point of time, none in the world had done it before. So let's work together towards this thing, because that's the thing which is going to help you in the world that you are going to step into in another 1.5-2 years. Okay, so now, coming now, all this thing, I'll give you a case study of Cheil. Now Cheil, our tagline, everybody knows marketing, everybody knows tagline. Our tagline was ideas that move. Basically, we had said that we, because it's advertising, it's communication, we used to say that we have ideas which are going to move products, which are going to move brands, not only products, move brands. So that was the tagline. We have to learn, unlearn, relearn. And this is what we changed to. We are saying we are the agency of now. Basically, today is the reality. Tomorrow, we don't know. So we are the agency of now. We are agile. We are flexible. We are driving creativity through technology. We have an innovation lab. So, okay, let me give you an example. I don't know if you guys have heard of an award called Cannes. Have you? Okay. So Cannes is the largest, for people who are not very clear, I'm just giving a little more detail. Cannes is the largest advertising or idea award in the world. and it is any win in Cannes is considered to be the ultimate in terms of creative work. Okay, this year Cheil India won 2 Cannes, one bronze and one silver, and the bronze is in the innovation category. So what we have done, the agency Cheil, my organization, we have an innovation lab, something called an innovation lab, where we are saying that if you have an idea, we will execute it. Okay, so the idea can be, rather than this boring classroom seating, theater, blah, 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 I want slides to flash everywhere. You know, when I'm talking about agility, I want a monkey jumping from tree to tree, coming into all the walls, so that the agility sticks to your mind. Right, so this is an idea. Can it be done? Is there wiring here, whatever, whatever. How can it be executed is what the innovation lab does. What we want Cannes for is good vibes. Read up good vibes. Good vibes is an app. If you put it in your phone, if you download it in your phone, deaf and dumb people are able to send and receive messages. Blind, deaf and dumb people are able to send and receive messages. They use braille and vibrations. So this is, we are planning to get it patented also. So this is an innovative idea which is reaching more and more consumers. So that was the area which was unexplored, people who are differently able. So we have reached out to them through this. Plus, obviously, the good to the whole society as a whole, to the whole world as a whole. So many countries now want to use it. Many mobile companies now want to use it as part of their embedded software in their mobile phones. So that's the kind of work we do. We could not have done it if we had not been agile enough or flexible enough to change quickly our USP, our deliverables. This, another one which won Cannes was the Seema Nagar project, because I'm talking about Cannes, I'm just saying this. Seema Nagar is a technical school which Samsung has opened across India. I think they have opened thousands of technical schools for girls. So this is this one girl. See the Seema Nagar advertisement in your... So this is this girl who has... It's a real story. So because it's a real story and real work, we got a silver for that. So you see, this is what the world is going. The world is rewarding work which is innovative, which is in with the times, which has a bigger, larger impact, and not just specialized into one vertical. These are the kind of work which are getting rewarded. FCB Ulka, let me not talk about Cheil. I'm very passionate about my own organization, so forget that. FCB Ulka is another advertising agency which has won, I don't know how many Cannes on a clip, on an idea called Shidur Khela. Have you seen that? So see it in YouTube, Sindur Khela, where they are saying, you've seen it, right, Anirudh? Yeah, he's just like this. Yeah. So... The Bengali tradition is that when the goddess Durga, we say bye-bye to goddess Durga on the fourth day, we play with the sindoor, right? Many of you would have seen, would not have seen, I don't know, in movies or somewhere. So they play with sindoor, it's like holi, but it seems only married women could, unsaid, only married women could play with the sindoor because they're married. So this idea was that why? The Shidur Khela means that you are taking the blessings of the goddess Durga, playing a joyful moment, and you are letting her go on her way and telling her come back next year with your blessings. Why does it have to be limited to married women? Why can't widows play? Why can't divorces play? Why can't unmarried women play? Why can't transgenders play? So this was this idea which tied up with Times of India, and they took this idea up and they have made a video. Say it. That has won so many Cannes. So see, the world is really, really now, it's VUCA. You don't know what's going to succeed. You don't know what's going to be the game changer. So continuously you need to just go ahead, follow your passion, drive towards excellence, rest, everything will fall in place. Everything. Okay, so I don't have much time now. I think it's time to wrap up, right? Yes? Right? Okay. So any questions if you have, or else I'm available in LinkedIn. Please feel free to connect and ask your questions. But right now I can take two or three. Tell me.
Ma'am, like same as Gaurav, I'm from engineering background. I've worked for event management company as an HR, assistant HR,
mm-hmm.
where I found out like in engineering I was not able to get like why I'm doing my technical job. So at the end I find out that I'm good with people. So I get into the HR zone. But there I find out that I'm good at getting funds and sponsorship from other companies to us.
Okay. So again, you might have multiple talents. Find out what you really want to do.
Exactly. So, ma'am, you covered. How to find out what's our desire, what we are going to do.
So, yes. So you went through a whole process. You went through two jobs and then you figured out and all. I'm saying right now, find the subject which, because see, everybody might not have the bandwidth, opportunity or the time to go through that two cycle and figure out what they want. So I'm saying think back, take a step back and see which subject really drives you. And it should not be dependent on the faculty, only. So usually it is like that, the teacher is fantastic, teaches so well, so my interest in the subject is going up and up and up. It should not be the only driver. It drives, that's true. But it should not be the only driver because you got fantastic faculty members sitting here. So they might drive you in different directions. So figure out what you want to do. Then deep dive. Subject pe deep dive kar job. Aage chalke profession apne aap bane. Any other question or anything? Thank you. Any other thing that you want to answer for me to answer right now? Or we can take it offline in LinkedIn, whatever. Okay, so thank you very much, and I hope some part has gone in, part teacher not gone in, I think it was very, very nice being with all of you.